Max Daughtrey, Duncan, Oklahoma. On the west side of Duncan. Used to be in the country till I tied in the water. I've known about ICF for 20 years. I saw it on an NPR program or something a long time ago, and I said, if I ever build a house, that's what it's going to be. I'm an engineer by education. I ran three different companies, and so I figured that I could probably do it myself with, you know, some help. Went to the architect, and Jay was really good to us. He was not an ICF architect, so to speak, but he had done some, and he knew how to take the plans that he had and enlarge the walls to get the right square footage and everything for the plans itself. It worked out real well. It finally wound up being 2,800 square feet, which is probably bigger than what we needed, but it was what we wanted. So we actually have four bedrooms in this house if somebody wanted to use it, or three bedrooms and an office. And then it was just going around picking the different contractors that I wanted to use. I wanted to keep the business here, and so once you get the cement contractor and get him lined up and get the floor and everything in, then it all kind of falls in place. When David started putting up the styrofoam walls and getting it ready, I bet we had a dozen cars out here first two or three days, and then I had a crowd out here watching them when they were pouring the cement from the end of the walls. People couldn't believe it. They looked at the styrofoam and said, that's your walls? And I said, well, that's part of it. There's 6 inches of concrete down through the middle of that thing. And that got their attention, and got a lot of attention. A lot of them were skeptical, especially your sheetrock people and your brick builders. But once they came out and they actually saw the structure and the plastic in the sides of the blocks and everything, they really didn't have a problem. I mean, they just did it like it was a regular house. You can make it complex. All these people have done construction for years and years and years. It just takes them a little bit to get in there and finally figure it out, where they could put their nails, where they could put their screws, and where they could attach the bricks to. And besides that, it's not really that much more complex than anything else. You have to have a good relationship with your banker. If, like in this area, there's been no other ICFs built, and explain to him what you're doing and why you're doing it. Because of the energy cost and how more efficient it is, and so on and so forth. I do believe it was not much more, if any, than a stick house with all this, you know, good insulation and all the amenities that we would put into it. And I think you can go ahead and get him to come around to the idea that, yeah, I will finance this project. And that's what they finally did. I had the chairman of the board down here, and he liked the idea, very interested in it, and that's how I've got the banker on board. I set up a construction account, and I'd walk in once a week with my invoices I'd paid and give it to him and say, could you put this in a construction account? And sure enough, they just put the money in construction account as I wrote them. They never slowed me down. I wrote some checks for $80,000 and $100,000. I never backed off of it. You just have to have a good relationship with your banker. Otherwise, you're going to be in a problem. If you're building it yourself, I mean, that's what I found. My average bill out here will run about $225 a month. But you have to remember, I've got over 100 lights in the ceiling in this place. I've got two pumps running on the koi pond all the time, 24 hours a day. I've got a barn over there with lights in it. So for $200 a month, I'm getting my bang for my buck. getting twice as much or three times as much as what I did out of the other house, and all I was doing was paying for the heating and cooling. We can have 50 mile an hour winds out here on top of this hill. We don't even know it. It's just a totally different world. It's always almost 70 degrees in here year round. We don't ever touch the thermostat. It's our secure castle. You walk into this house, you feel comfortable when you walk into it. We're very comfortable in the way it's laid out. We sat out on our back porch and watched the most beautiful sunset you've ever seen. We just flat enjoy this house. I mean, it's the best investment I ever made.